everything financially about me is in jeopardy.
Craig Newman is one of over 300,000 people impacted by the recent data breach at the University of Maryland. The names, birth dates, university ID numbers, and social security numbers of countless past and current members of the school's community, all out there for the taking. President Wallace Lowe, talking exclusively with the Capitol News Service for the first time since it happened, says the financial toll will be enormous.
These costs can be very, very, very high. And we're not talking about millions of dollars. We're talking about tens of millions of dollars.
The cost to the university will include 5 years of free credit monitoring for victims, which Lowe says may cost up to $20 for each individual who elects to sign up. The anticipated cost of that is over $6 million, and possibly more. And the expenses don't stop there.
There's the cost of bringing all these external consultants to assist in minimizing the risk of a future attack.
Finally, there's the actual preventative measures to be undertaken, like encrypting databases, which may have made the breach much more difficult to have pulled off.
Our preliminary estimates is that to encrypt will be around $20 to $30 million.
And the 300,000 plus victims whose social security numbers were compromised now run the risk of identity theft, which they may have to deal with for years to come.
That leaves me holding the empty money bag. And it makes me angry if you can't tell that in my tone already.
Lowe says that the social security numbers weren't purged in order to allow alumni who only had social security numbers as their school ID to obtain transcripts and other information. That system changed in the late 1990s.
It's not like, you know, people were sitting around saying, well, you know, we're careless and just keep the social security numbers there. If we had expunged those, there's no way you can get your information.
But that's just not good enough for some.
The university makes it look like they're really trying to help us. And I don't really buy it. I think it hurts everybody. All 309,000 people, and the university is just trying to cover its rear end.
The breach at the University of Maryland is now under investigation by state and federal agencies and the Secret Service. From Annapolis, I'm Nicholas Munson, CNS TV.